Guys, how's it going? We have another card for review. This is the GeForce GTX OCV3 edition. This is 1650. It's a 4 GB DDR6, I guess. Anyway, this is not a knockoff, so I'm hoping this will be a lot better than the last one we went through. There's the back. This retails for about $217 shipped, which is not bad for a brand name card. I'm hoping we can just throw it in and it works. That'd be nice. I'll have a quick look in here. I will say the one thing that's nice about the returns on Amazon, that they will actually come to your door and pick up the product now, which is pretty cool. Before you had to take it to the post office, but there's your card, the starter guide. It's in every English or every language. This card is much smaller than the last one I worked on or tried out, but it's not a knockoff, so I'm sure it'll work better. Well, look at that, it's sealed. Nice and compact. It's a small computer anyway, so this is going to work out pretty good. Still got the guard on it. The other one I got didn't have a guard on the PCIe slot. Oh yeah, this one's definitely new. It's very nice. Oh yeah, and it's got all the plugs and everything. The other one didn't have that either. Let's see what they got here. Oh, one of them is the right. This one here, you need an adapter for it. And then you got your digital. It's cool. Oh, leave it there. There's the bottom. Pretty straightforward card. I like it. It's very light too, so you don't have to worry about sag. Replacing these fans down the road will be easy because they're that size. I have a couple of those laying around. Sweet. Yep, I like it. From what I can tell, it looks like the all the RAM chips are all heat synced over here. Yeah, it looks good. Cool. Let's throw it in, try it out. I want to try gaming with it. Well, here we go again. At least I have more of a half-decent case to dig into and put the card in. It's not floating around on the case on the table this time. This is my Kermit build. Let's crack it open and see if this card actually works. There, hopefully you got a decent view. It's Kermit. Sorry about the lighting in here. This isn't normally where I make videos, so you get what you get. Yeah, let's unplug it, or, well, flip it off anyway. Oh yeah, this card is missing the bracket on the end. Piece is missing. So it's just basically sitting in there. It's kind of risky, but it worked. That's for the lights. Take that out. Fish that out some other way, maybe through there. The card. Untouched, unmolested, fresh from the factory, I'm hoping. Now, why isn't it fitting? You're kidding me, right? There we go. Yeah. Okay, this is gonna need a power source. Which one is what? Get that out. It's dry. Actually, we'll leave that out for now. We need a power source here. Now, I'm pretty sure this was compatible. It's the same. Yellow was on the bottom. Yellow was on the bottom. Okay, we're good. There we go. Alright. Let's HDMI this bitch and hopefully it works. Please work. This has been going on for a week. Three cards later. Or two anyway. We'll just leave it open for now. Let's just move the card back. Yes, we'll leave the side off. Let it run for a bit. See, I'll turn it back on. Yay! It's a good sign. Nice and quick. If there's any issues with this card. It's my dog. He's dead. My dead dog. Well, I'm going to give him a minute to see if Windows picks up on the drivers. Other than that, I'll have to go download them. Yeah, Windows actually picked up on the drivers right away. What's got a NVIDIA control panel in here? Huh. I'm curious to see what's just coming up here. Yeah. So their driver's installed. Let's try Diablo 4, see if that works. That's the most important. The other games pretty much run on anything, so this is the one she wants to play. And wow, looks very smooth. Way smoother than that. That last knockoff card was, it was smooth, but not as smooth as this. Actually, I'm kind of jealous. This is smoother than my card. Start. See what it looks like. Game. And that's right out of the box. No drivers. Well, no real drivers to download. I mean, it's using the ones that were on from the last card. Maybe they're universal. I don't know. But it's working. If there was an issue, it would have showed up already. Wow. That's pretty good. I'm going to let it sit for a while. And burn the card in, basically. But it looks good. We'll make sure the fans work properly and everything else. But hey, for the price, it's not worth it getting the knockoff cards. Just go for the lowest end you could find. I like it that MSI has come up with a card that's under $300, like $217 shipped. Is pretty good. Later, guys. Oh, if I have any issues with it, I'll be sure to do a follow-up.